Hi friends, welcome back to Share in Zoology. See, in this session, I'm going to explain about the cleavage in humans. We know about cleavage. Cleavage means division of zygote. See, we know fertilization takes place in fallopian tube. After fertilization, this fertilization is followed by the zygote undergo repeated division. The zygote undergo repeated division within this fallopian tube. And this division is a type of mitotic division. So this fertilization is followed by repeated mitosis. Fertilization is followed by repeated mitosis in activated egg. Repeated mitosis in activated egg means egg is activated by the sperm penetration. So activated egg means fertilized egg. So these fertilized egg undergo repeated mitosis called as cleavage. First of all, we are going to learn about different planes of this cleavage. Different planes of this cleavage. See here, this one is egg. Animal pole and vegetable pole of this egg. See here, suppose this one is a fertilized egg. This is a fertilized egg. Or activated egg. And here, the different planes of cleavage includes. First one, meridional plane. Second one, vertical plane. Then third one, equatorial plane. Fourth one, latitudinal or transverse or horizontal plane. So these are the different planes of cleavage. They are meridional plane, vertical plane, equatorial plane, latitudinal or transverse or horizontal plane. First one is meridional plane. This meridional plane here, this plane passes through the median animal vegetal axis. It passes through the median animal vegetal axis. So here, the cleavage furrow passes through the median animal vegetal axis, which bisect this zygote. Which bisect this zygote to two equal halves. So this plane bisect this zygote to two equal halves. This plane is known as meridional plane. So this is the meridional plane. Second one is vertical plane. Second plane is vertical. So vertical plane means the plane parallel to the meridional plane. These vertical planes are parallel to the meridional plane, but not passes through the median animal vegetal axis. See, it also passes through the animal vegetal axis, but not through the median animal vegetal axis. So the vertical plane parallel to the meridional plane, not through the median animal vegetal axis. And this vertical plane does not bisect the egg into two equal halves. This vertical plane does not bisect the egg into two equal halves. See here, suppose this is a fertilized egg, and these are vertical planes. So this vertical plane does not bisect the egg into equal halves. This plane is called as vertical plane. So this form vertical plane. Then third one is equatorial plane. That is equatorial. This equatorial plane is right angle to animal vegetal axis. It is right angle to animal vegetal axis and equidistance from animal pole and vegetal pole. This plane is called as equatorial plane. This equatorial plane of division result equal blastomeres in animal pole and vegetal pole. So this equatorial plane resulted equal blastomeres in animal and vegetal hemisphere. This plane is called as equatorial plane. Last one, latitudinal or transverse or horizontal plane. Latitudinal plane or transverse plane or horizontal plane. This latitudinal plane are parallel. This latitudinal plane are parallel to this equatorial plane. These latitudinal planes are parallel to this equatorial plane, but it is shifted to one side of this equatorial plane. So it is parallel to this latitudinal plane or parallel to this equatorial plane, but shifted to one side, shifted to one side of this equatorial plane. As a result, the blastomeres produced in animal and vegetal hemispheres are not equal. This is zygote and these are latitudinal division. As a result of this latitudinal division, the blastomeres formed in animal and vegetal hemispheres are not equal as a result of this latitudinal or transverse or horizontal plane of cleavage. These are the different planes of cleavage. Planes are meridional plane, then vertical plane, equatorial plane and latitudinal plane. These are the different planes of cleavage. Next is human cleavage. See here, you know, fertilization takes place in the ampulla of fallopian tube. Here, this is fertilization. Sperm penetrate this egg and fertilization takes place in the fallopian tube. Okay. And this one is the fertilized egg. This fertilized egg is called as zygote. Fertilized egg is zygote. We know after fertilization, by the cortical reaction, the zona pellucida become hardened. So this one is the hardened zona pellucida. The hardened zona pellucida. The hardened zona pellucida here, around the zygote. After this fertilization, the first cleavage begins a day later. So the first cleavage begins after 24 hours. The first division, this is the first division. The first division begins after 24 hours. So in human, the first cleavage begins after 24 hours. And here in humans, this is the first cleavage. Suppose this one is zygote. And this zygote undergo first cleavage. What is this plane? That means a median animal vegetal axis plane is known as meridional plane. So in humans, the first cleavage is a meridional plane or meridional plane. So as a result of this meridional division, two cells are formed. Now become two-celled embryo. This is two-celled embryo. So the zygote undergo first division to form a two-celled embryo and first cleavage plane is meridional. About 1.5 day after fertilization, about 1.5 day after fertilization, this embryo become two-celled. So in this two-celled embryo, Each cell formed as a result of cleavage. Each cell formed as a result of cleavage called as blastomere. So two-cell embryo means two blastomeres. However, in the second cleavage, one of these blastomere divide meridionally. In the second cleavage, one of the blastomere divide meridionally. So a meridional division, one of the blastomere divide meridionally and other divide equatorially. So in the second cleavage, one of this blastomere divide meridionally, other one divide equatorial, equatorial plane. This type of cleavage in humans called as rotational cleavage. This type of cleavage in humans called as rotational cleavage. So human cleavage is rotational cleavage. See, along with this division, along with the division of this zygote or division of the embryo, the ciliary cells are here. We know fallopian tube, inner wall house ciliary cells, and the middle muscular layer of fallopian tube. The ciliary movement as well as the muscular movement of fallopian tube push this embryo toward the uterus along with this cleavage. So after fertilization, this embryo is pushed towards the uterus by the ciliary as well as the muscular movement of fallopian tube. And this cleavage occurs along with this journey. Then this mammalian blastomeres do not all divide at the same time. And during the second cleavage, one of these cells divide more rapidly than other one and form a three-celled embryonic stage. So mammalian embryo do not all divide at the same time. Thus, mammalian embryo do not increase exponentially. This mammalian embryo does do not increase exponentially like 2 to 4, 4 to 8. But frequently contain odd numbers also. Odd number stage also seen in the mammalian embryonic cleavage. Then this zygote continue the division to form 3-cell, 4-celled embryo. Then 8-celled embryo. So this cleavage continues. It becomes 8-celled embryo. That means the zygote become 2-celled embryo, 4-celled embryo, 8-celled embryo, 16-celled embryo. Such 8 to 16-celled embryo. 8 to 16-celled embryo called as morula. By this cleavage, the 8 to 16 celled embryonic stage is called as morula stage. Then mammalian cleavage are the slowest among the animal kingdom. So the cleavage in mammalian egg are the slowest among the animal kingdom. Here this form the genome, nucleus and genome of this egg or zygote or embryo. Unlike the genome of rapidly developing animals. Unlike the genome of rapidly developing animals, the mammalian genome activated at the very early embryonic stage. That is, the mammalian genome become activated and expressed during the early embryonic stage. That means in 4-celled or 8-celled stage. Mammalian genome expressed and activated during this 4-celled or 8-celled embryonic stage. Mammalian genome expressed at the very beginning of the embryonic life. That means in the 4-celled or 8-celled embryonic stage, the gene expression begins. See here, in this cleavage, the number of cells increases. Number of cells increases means from the zygote, it increases to 2-celled embryo, 4 celled embryo, 8 celled embryo, 16 celled embryo. So the number of cells increases during the cleavage. But what happened to the cell size? The cell size decreases during this cleavage. Number of cells increases, but the cell size decreases. That is as a result of here this cleavage. That single-celled zygote undergo repeated division to form several nucleated cell. So only the number of cells increases, but the cell size decreases. Why? This cleavage is a type of mitotic division. As a result, the cell multiplication takes place. And copies of the zygote are actually formed. All these cells having the same genotype of this zygote. All the 16 cells of this morula have the same genotype of this zygote. Because this cleavage is a mitotic division. We know in cell cycle, different phases of cell cycle includes G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase, and mitotic phase. But here in cleavage, it is also mitotic division, but no growth phase in cleavage. So the growth phase absent. So cleavage includes a mitotic division, but it has only synthetic and mitotic phase. So it includes only S phase and M phase. Synthetic and mitotic phase occurs during this cleavage. As a result, no growth occurs in this cleavage. In this mitotic division, no growth occurs. So only number of cells increases, but the cell size decreases because no growth phase in this cleavage. See, this is a 16-celled stage, morula stage. The total cytoplasmic volume, of this morula is equal to the cytoplasmic volume of zygote. Because during this cleavage, no growth occurs in this cell. Only the number of cells increases. So the total cytoplasmic volume of this morula is equal to the cytoplasm of the zygote. Because during this cleavage, the zygote undergo repeated division to form several nucleated cells. This is morula stage. Then, this zygote as well as this early blastomias. Zygote as well as early blastomias are totipotent. Means have the ability to differentiate it into an entire organism. So the zygote as well as this early blastomias are totipotent or equipotent. That means each of these cell have the ability to differentiate it into an entire organism. See, in human cleavage is called as indeterminative. Indeterminative cleavage means suppose this is a 4-celled embryo. Each of these blastomias are totipotent or equipotent. That means each of these blastomia have the ability to differentiate it into an entire organism. So the fate of this blastomia is not predetermined. This blastomia can develop into any type of structure in the organism. That type of cleavage is known as indeterminative. The fate of the blastomias are not predetermined. This indeterminative cleavage seen in vertebrates. So human cleavage is indeterminative. But in some animals like annelids, mollusks, echinodermates, etc., the fate of the blastomias are predetermined. Means suppose this one is a blastomia. This blastomia become a particular organ. Suppose if this blastomia become heart,
the fate of the blastomere is predetermined. So here, the fate of the blastomeres are predetermined. A particular blastomere become a particular organ. The removal of this particular blastomere will affect the development of that particular organ. And that developed organism will become deficient or failure in the development of such organ. Such cleavage is known as determinative. Such cleavage called as determinative cleavage. This determinative cleavage seen in annelids, mollusks, echinoderms, etc. But in some invertebrates like hemichordate and all vertebrates have indeterminate cleavage. The fate of the blastomeres are not predetermined. So human cleavage is indeterminative cleavage. Then at this 8-celled stage, the mammalian embryo undergo a striking changes known as compaction. See, compaction means in the 8-celled stage, the cell adhesion protein, E-cadherin. The cell adhesion protein such as E-cadherin expressed. So in the 8-celled stage, the cell adhesion protein E-cadherin expressed. As a result, this blastomere suddenly huddled or glued together. Huddled together to form a compact ball-like structure. This is called as compaction. So at this 8-celled stage, the E-cadherin expressed, which causes the adhesion or huddling of the blastomeres together and form a ball-like structure. This is called as compaction. Then the cells of the 8-celled compact ball. And the cells of the 8-celled this compact ball divides to form the 16-celled morula. Then this morula contains a group of internal and external cells. So this morula contain a group of external cells as well as internal cells. And here, tight junctions are seen in this, seen in between this external cell. Tight junctions are seen in between the external cells. So they are very tightly bounded together. And gap junctions are seen between the internal cell. It allows the transfer of ions, molecules, etc. between the cell, this gap junction. So two types of cells are here, a group of external and a group of internal cell. Tight junctions are seen in between the external cell and gap junctions are seen in between internal cell. Here, these are external cells. So, by this compaction, a group of external cells and a group of internal cells formed. Here, this external cells produce a fluid. Here, the external cells produce some fluid into the internal cell. Fluid causes the pushing of this internal cell and develop a new cavity. By enlarging this cavity, a new cavity is here formed. This newly formed cavity called as blastocoel. This newly formed cavity called as blastocoel. Now this this group of outer or external cell, this group of outer or external cell called as tropoblast, and a group of inner cell mass, a group of inner cell mass called as embryoblast. We will discuss in later about this tropoblast and embryoblast. Anyway, this compacted morula undergo a number of changes, and all these changes are collectively called as blastulation. As a result of this blastulation, this morula is converted to this stage is known as blastula. As a result of blastulation, this morula is converted to blastula, and this is the blastula, and this human blastula is called as blastocyst. This human blastula called as blastocyst is human blastula. So this human blastula called as blastocyst. Next we are going to learn about the structure of this blastocyst. This is the blastocyst. And this is the outer layer. This is the external cell. This external cell or outer cell mass. This external cell or outer cell mass called tropoblast. This external cell or outer cell mass called as tropoblast or ectoderm. This outer cell mass is known as, this group of external cell or outer cell mass called as tropoblast or trop ectoderm. Then these are a group of inner cell mass. This inner cell mass called embryoblast. Is that a group of inner cell mass? This inner cell mass called as embryoblast. So outer cell mass and inner cell mass. Outer cell mass is tropoblast or trop ectoderm. Inner cell mass is embryoblast. And this is a cavity. This cavity is called as blastocoel. This is the structure of this blastocyst. And among this, these are the cells of tropoblast. These cells of tropoblast nearer to this inner cell mass, the cells of tropoblast nearer to this inner cell mass called cells of rubber. The cells of tropoblast nearer to the inner cell mass called as cells of rubber. So this is the structure of blastocyst. And here, why this inner cell mass is called as embryoblast? Because this inner cell mass contains stem cells. This inner cell mass contains stem cells. But the stem cells are not totipotent. These stem cells in inner cell mass are pluripotent. That means have the ability to differentiate into almost all type of cell in body. So these pluripotent stem cells differentiated from different types of cells, different types of tissue, and form different types of organs, organ system, and form organism. So the actual embryo, the embryo proper is this inner cell mass. Because only inner cell mass contain this stem cell. As a result, only this inner cell mass will become developed as the embryo or fetus. So only this part will become embryo in future. This inner cell mass become embryo in future. So the inner cell mass is called as embryoblast, because these inner cell mass differentiated to form. In future, different types of organs are formed from this inner cell mass. As a result, this inner cell mass differentiated to form the organism or fetus. So if the fetus or organism are formed from this inner cell mass, thereby the inner cell mass, this inner cell mass is called as embryoblast. But trophoblast, the word trophine, trophine means to nourish. So the main function of trophoblast is to nourish the embryo. We will discuss in later about the trophoblast and functions of this lice. Anyway, this is the trophoblast. So this blastocyst stage reaches the uterus. This blastocyst stage reaches the uterus. About 4 days after fertilization, this blastocyst reaches the uterus. About 4 days after fertilization, this blastocyst reaches the uterus. But we know the cleavage takes place inside the zona pellucida membrane. This is the zona membrane. This zona pellucida membrane remains even in this blastocyst stage also. The zona membrane formed in fertilization are found in this blastocyst stage also. So within the uterus, about 5 days after fertilization, this blastocyst expands. This blastocyst try to expand. At the same time, these are the trophoblasts. These cells are called as trophoblasts. These trophoblasts secrete trypsin-like proteases. We already studied the chemical nature of this zona pellucida. It's a protein membrane. When this trophoblast secrete this trypsin-like proteases, what happened? A hole is formed in this zona pellucida. Then by the expanding as well as the secretion of protease enzyme, the zona pellucida membrane ruptured. And this blastocyst fused from this trophoblast. See, this is the trophoblast. This blastocyst fused through this hole of this zona pellucida and causes the shedding of the zona pellucida membrane. So through this hole, this blastocyst escaped from this zona pellucida. Through this hole, this blastocyst fused and escaped from the zona pellucida. And it takes about 5 days after fertilization. So the zona pellucida membrane removed. Now this trophoblast is exposed. And now this trophoblast can attach to the endometrium of uterus. This is the endometrium. Can attach the endometrium of uterus. And this trophoblast of this blastocyst get attached to the endometrium of uterus and implanted here. We will discuss about the implantation in my next video. Okay, in this session, we completed cleavage, blastulation, and the structure of blastocyst. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, share, and subscribe my channel, Sharing Zoology. Okay.